for your interest in our work based on capacity of microwave sensor for toxic vapor detection in polluted environment. Good morning, everybody. This work is carried out at EMS near Bordeaux with close collaboration with UMN in Lille, France, Xlim in Limoges, and with also close collaboration with Sintra in Singapore. As you know, there is a need for gas sensor and especially for environmental pollution monitoring because sensors currently used have too long response and recovery times, are very energy and cost intensive, why there is this urgent need for highly sensitive and selective sensor. The aim of this study is to develop a new kind of sensors, a very low-cost sensor and communicated also sensors in order to the aim is to work for the application of Internet of Things. For this we need to work on gigahertz area. And the target species that I will try to detect in this study, it will be the ethanol vapor, I mean volatile organic compound. First, let me present the context of this project. This study is a part of a big project, which means carbon and microwave-based ultra-sensitive gas sensor. This project is based on microwave sensor associated with carbonic materials such as graphene and carbon nanotube, and is funded by French National Agency of Research. The working principle of this sensor is presented here. As you can see, when we have presence of gas molecules, it introduces make modification of physical chemical properties, and then we have modification of the electrical properties of carbon materials such as permittivity or conductivity of this material. Then it will introduce perturbation of electromagnetic field, I mean electric or magnetic field. In order to measure this perturbation, we need to design some devices working on high frequency and to track the shift of frequency or the shift on amplitude here in decibel. For this, we design a microwave resonator and it's a bandpass filter. There is many advantages for the choice of materials or technology or the geometry of this device. First, we use carbon materials thanks to their high sensitivity for gas target species, and also totally integrated, and it can work on room temperature. We did not use temperature to desorb or adsorb some gases. Also, we use inkjet printing as a technology here, thanks to the low cost, because remember that in this project, our challenge is to produce a very low-cost sensor, and also we can fabricate easily a planar circuit. Why planar circuits? Because for this I will choose a planar technology in microwave, no volumic technology. And first, let me present the working of this microwave resonator. Here, as you can see, on this microwave resonator, there is two channels. The two channels are symmetric on geometry, but there is difference. One, it will be the reference. There is difference because one, it will be a reference, and the second will be the sensitive channel. And this sensitive channel, we will print our sensitive layer here. And thanks to the differential detection, we can detect just our target species thanks to the sensitivity. No influence of temperature or pressure or some other interferent species. on this device. Also, there is a good thing on this device. This device is designed to work in a range frequency of 1 GHz to 6 GHz. This make easy to go for wireless communication. And also is totally passive because it's a filter, no consume energy, and we can make interrogation of this sensor without any instrumentation to this sensor. And finally, we can go to the Internet of Things application. After presentation of the context, let me present now the outline of this study. First, I will start with the sensor modeling and design. I will show the simulation, the results of simulation, then manufacturing and validation of this device, and after characterization and ethanol and as vapor in this study, finally, I sum up with conclusion and prospect. Here you have details of the geometry of this sensor. As I said, we have here the reference and here the sensitive channel. On red, you can see the sensitive materials. The choice of sensor materials is presented here. We use Epson photopaper as flexible substrate. Here on this study, I showed just for paper, but we have other kind of sensor based on Kapton also substrate. The thickness of this substrate is around 260 micrometers. Also, we use silver nanoparticles as metallic lines. For the sensitive layer, we use a commercial PEDOT PSS mutual carbon nanotube material. And one layer is around 600 nanometers. The geometric characteristic is shown here. I don't know, I cannot see the... No problem. There is a question of the working of this geometry, but anyway, we design here the network of 50 electrodes, and we designed also two devices. One with five, we print five layers, and the second we print 50 layers. The sensitive area surface based on the sensitive layer is around 45.72 square millimeter. After the presentation of this, the modeling of this sensor, here we make a full simulation thanks to the HFSS software. As you can see here, I present the S parameters. I mean the transmission and the reflection of the sensor versus frequency from 1 GHz to 6 GHz. As you can see, first we can see that we recorded two resonant frequency. The first one is around 2.4 GHz and the second one is around 4.7 GHz. You can see there is difference between the reference and also the sensitive layer. When we add our sensitive layer, it's a low a shift of frequency around 100 megahertz. And also there is difference when we print 5 and 50 layers is not the same also. It's a low other shift on frequency. And before here, I am showing directly how it's happened on the repetition of the electrical field. As you can see, on the first word, the electrical field is on the border of this resonator, but for the second mode, is here. Let me show the animation of this electrical and also magnetic field. As you can see, no response on the magnetic field because this is capacitive resonator and we have just to see the first and second mode where we have electrical field more intense. And because that we have on first mode two zones that we have E field very intense, and also in second mode we have three zones, we chose to print our sensitive material in three zones in order to make a maximum of perturbation of this electrical field. After the presentation of simulation and validation of the sensor, we fabricate this sensor thanks to printer D-Matix 2800, and we use paper Epson as I show before, and also silver nanoparticles from Novacentric, and also PDOT commercial PDOT. And finally, here you have the results of the fabricated sensor. Here is the sensitive channel based on 5 layers, and here the sensitive channel based on 50 layers. And every time we have a reference and sensitive channel in order to make differential measurements. Here there is presentation of electrical characterization, I mean the test setup. As you can see, I use a network, a vector network analyzer, and we make electrical characterization from 1 to 6 gigahertz. We use salt calibration, I mean short open load through calibration, and also for the device we develop a new kind of cell measurement, because it's very important and it takes time, because when we make measurement in gigahertz, it's not easy to make measurement directly with classical cell, because here we develop this cell in order to work on high frequency, is adapted really for this application, as you can see. After this presentation of test setup, here you have the measurement of this sensor, the electrical measurement. We can see that the first mod is very close to the first mod that we simulate, but for the second mod we have some problem of measurement. There is problem of adaptation. Here we can see this between reflection and transmission, and this we are now still working in order to understand why we have this problem. Maybe it's because of our salt calibration, or because our cell measurement. We have not yet the response for this. And for the next study under gas, we will try to see the behavior of the first mod under ethanol. Here I present the characterization of sensor under gas, and is the experimental setup. For this experiment, I use nitrogen gas carrier gas, and we generate sequences of ethanol 0 ppm, 500 ppm, 1000 ppm, and 2000 ppm. Let me show now the real detection of this this concentration of different of ethanol. Here you can see the behavior of the device based on 5 layers, and here is the behavior of the sensitive also channel. And we can see that we have a shift of frequency. In order to estimate the shift of frequency, here you have the detail of the details of the sensitivity. You can see here we measure the differential frequency versus concentration. You can see that for five device based on 5 layers, we recorded 0.9 kilohertz per ppm. And for 50 layers, we device based on 50 layers, we recorded 1.3 kilohertz, which is very interesting, because when we increase our thickness of sensitive layer, it increases also sensitivity of sensor. Finally, I finish with the conclusion and prospect. In this presentation, we present we prove the feasibility of this very low cost sensor, and the new principle of sensor. I mean that it's totally passive, autonomous, and can really work for application of Internet of Things without any instrumentation. Because I insist about this, we can just to use a reader and to normalize the measurement before, and we know that there is shift of frequency, and we can make detection of gases. Thank you very much.